द थर्ड पार्ट इज स्टमक एंड हेयर इज अ सैक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर यू जस्ट सी हेयर. You can see here, this is just a sac like structure. It's a muscular sac like structure, and the food is break down here in this sac like structure. Half of the food means the partial breakdown of food occur in the stomach. The food is partially breakdown means half of the digestion occur in the stomach only. So it's a place where the further breakdown means the breakdown start from the mouth only. That breakdown is the only of carbohydrate, and then the further breakdown occur in the stomach because the wall of the stomach is releases gastric juices. The gastric juices, they help to digest the food, or they help to convert the food into the simpler form. So this conversion means occur in the stomach. So the food is partially digested in the stomach. Partial means half. So the half of the food is digested in the stomach, and after this digestion, the food moves to the small intestine. Means in the stomach, it become a thick paste like structure, semi solid structure. Means like a sort of paste, a thick paste sort of structure is formed in the stomach when it mix with the gastric juices, and that thick paste is now moved to the small intestine. So here you can see this this one is small intestine. I'll show you here the middle portion, this one, the inner, this one portion is small intestine. And it's also very important part of this digestive system, because not only here the digestion completed, means whatever the half of the digestion is left, that is completed in the small intestine, that absorption also occur in the small intestine only. Means whatever the digestion occur, don't use my screen, just concentrate what I'm saying, because after explanation I will ask from you people only. And what I say, mute your mic, everyone. Don't disturb the class. My voice will not be audible to you if you will open your mic. That disturbs the class a lot. If you want to listen that in a proper way, you should keep your mic mute only. So small intestine is a very important organ of the digestive system, because here not only the digestion completed, because partially it is digested in the stomach, means half of the food is digested in the stomach, and rest half of the food is digested in small intestine, means the food is the digestion completed in the small intestine, you can say, means the digestion is start from the mouth and the food converted into the simpler form in the small intestine. Now the next important process also occur in the small intestine only, that is absorption, means the now it is converted into the small intestine. Maisha, what happened to you? I'll block you if you behave like this. Don't disturb the class like this. When I ask you to say something, then only you raise your hand and unmute, and at that time only. If you continuously disturb my class, I will block you. Whoever is doing, is visible on my screen, you know. So don't behave like this. Listen properly, and means what I am saying, just concentrate on that, because I'll ask after that from you only what I explain. So small intestine is a place where the rest of means where absorption also occur, means these food, the nutrient which are here in the small intestine, now how they move to the different part of the body, means these nutrients are needed by the all cell. Our body is made up of cell, and each cell need these nutrients. So how it move to the every cell? So they move through the these the small finger like projections are there in the small intestine, and from these finger like projections, the food is absorbed and into the blood vessels, you can say, or into the blood, it goes into the blood. So this is the place where the absorption is also occur. The useful nutrient, they are absorbed by the blood. Means this finger like projection or the finger like structure that are called villi, villi, villi. They just what you can say, having the blood vessels on it, and they richly supplied with the blood vessels. So the nutrient move into the blood vessels, and the blood vessels carry the nutrient to the all part of the body, to every cell of the body where they are needed. So absorption also occur in the small intestine. After small intestine means whatever the useful substances, they move to the blood carry to the all body parts, or you can say to the each cell. And then whatever the useless substances, the waste product, the undigested part, they move to the large intestine. So large intestine function is to hold the undigested food, the food that cannot be digested further. Means whatever the digestion occur, and the complex food that is converted into the simpler, that is absorbed by through the villi into the blood. And now the waste product, the food which is not digested, now the food, now it's just a waste only, that is moved to the large intestine. So the large intestine hold the undigested food that cannot be digested further. And of course, in that food, the water content is also there. So its function is to absorb the extra water, whatever there in the waste products. So here in large intestine, whatever the extra water is there in the waste product, that is absorbed by the large intestine, and it hold the undigested food also. And after interval, that is excreted out through the anus. So anus is the opening opening of this large intestine. You can say large intestine open into rectum, and rectum having a small opening, that is anus. And through the anus, this the waste product is excreted out. The waste product, the semi-solid waste that is excreted out, that is called feces. So feces are removed from the body through the anus. The food enter through the mouth, and then the whole digestion occur. It from the mouth through the esophagus, it reach into the stomach. Here some digestion occur. Then it move to the small intestine. The digestion completed in a small intestine. Then it move to the large intestine, and then from large means the large intestine. The opening of the large intestine is anus, and through the anus, this this product is excreted out, and that's very important. To excrete or to eliminate or get rid of the waste, because these are very harmful. They having the harmful substances in it. They are the poisonous substances in it. If they will be in the body, they will be harmful for the body. A person can lead to death even. So the waste product should be eliminated or excreted out. Liver is also a very important organ of digestive system. It plays many roles, but right now I'm just telling you that it releases bile juice. The bile juice that helpful to digest the fats, means help to break down the fat mechanically. It's break down fat into the smaller particles. So liver play very, very important role in digestion, and it play along with the digestion other role also. Liver is very important organ of the digestive system, you can say. It not only what you can say releases bile juice that helpful in the digestion of the fats. It breaks the fat into the smaller particles, mean the bigger particles or bigger globules of the fat converted into the simpler particles or the smaller droplets, that with the help of bile juice only. And the bile juice is released from the liver. And along with that, one more function of liver, that liver is stored the extra glucose, whatever there in the body. means the food which is digested, and now it goes into the blood, and the cell is used up, and whatever extra is left in the blood, that not left in the blood, that is stored in the liver in the form of glycogen. Means the glucose converted into the glycogen, and that is stored in the liver. At the time of need, that glycogen again converted into glucose, and it provide energy to the organism. Like some at the time of fasting, or when somebody is ill, not able to eat in a proper way, or the food is not available for few days, what happened? The food which is stored in the liver in the form of glycogen, that is converted into glucose, and it provide energy again. So it act as a storage organ for the glucose as well. Means the carbohydrates are stored in the liver, and that provide energy at the time of need. So liver is also play a very important role in digestion. So this all about the digestive system. Now Ibrahim, mean different organ of the digestive system. Yes, Ibrahim. Am I audible? Suddenly, no response is there. Habiba Asif.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Tell me the different organ of the digestive system.
Then the different organs of digestive system are first mouth, second intestine, third stomach, fourth small intestine, fifth liver, sixth large intestine, and seventh anus.
Yes. Huda Sadiq. But the what happened? What is the function of mouth? What happened to the mouth? What happened in mouth? What occurs here? Yes.
The function of mouth.
Okay, very good. Afan. Yes. What I say, if you want to say something, raise your hand only. Don't speak like this. It disturbs the class. Now, Afan, you tell me the function of food pipe. Function of food pipe.
Food passes from the mouth through the thin, long,
Okay, so the function of the food pipe is just to pass the food from mouth to the stomach. Yes? Okay. And this is Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr. He is there, but I don't know. Yes, Abu Bakr. What is the function of his stomach? What occur in his stomach? Yes, Abu Bakr. Yes. It's a sac-like structure where the food is broken down further further, how much partially the food is digested here? Half of the digestion occur in the stomach only. And then what happened in the small intestine? Yes, Simra. Simra, you tell me. Simra. Okay. Yes, yes, the small intestine. So here the digestion is completed, means half of the digestion occurs in the stomach and rest half is done in the small intestine, and then as well as the absorption also occur in this portion only. So absorption also occur in the small intestine. And then large intestine, it just hold the waste product, whatever the waste is left, that move to the large intestine, and the extra water which is present in the excess water which is present in the waste product, that is also absorbed by the large intestine. And then anus is the opening through which the feces excreted out or the waste product excreted out. Liver is the largest gland, and that play a very important role in digestion. So it's very important. It produces bile juice, so that helpful in the breakdown of fats. So now the time is over and the end of the class. So whatever I taught today, you just have to go through it, revise it. In the next class I will ask related to it. Okay, you revise all the content whatever I taught today.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay.